What's up, guys? Welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman. And so today we're gonna make a 2D physics platformer game. So this is what we're making today. A 2D physics platformer game in Game Maker Studio 2. If you don't have Game Maker Studio 2, I will leave a link down in the description below so you can download it. Alright, so for this video, we're gonna aim for 50 likes. So hit the like button and let's continue. So here is our Game Maker Studio, and let's go File New. Now, when you first open Game Maker Studio, you can select from Game Maker Language or Drag and Drop. Okay, so we are going to select Drag and Drop. No coding. Okay, so let's call this. What can we call this? We're gonna call it. Let's call it Le Rolling Ball. Okay, so we're gonna start from scratch. Okay, so which means that we have to create some sprites. Okay, let's make the Pokemon ball first. Okay. That looks done to me. Okay, let's move on to the next one. We're gonna paint it. We're gonna make it purple. Okay, just because we can. This is gonna be our wall. Give it some patterns or something, so it's not so bland. There we go. We're done with the sprites. Let's set the room size to 640 by 480. You can set it to whatever you like. Let's zoom in so we can see what we're doing. Maybe change the background color. I always choose some sort of purple. Let me see. What color can we use? Okay, so let's make four objects. Create new object. Assign the sprites. The first one is going to be our Pokemon ball. Make another object. This is going to be our purple pattern. And this one here is going to be just purple. And now the last one is just going to be our C for code. Don't worry, we're not going to do any actual coding. Click on the instance layer and let's drag our objects into the screen. This is going to be the floor. Maybe make this bigger. Yeah, so we basically are making a box. Maybe let's put this outside so we can't see them. So now let's enable physics for the room. If you run the game, you're gonna notice that nothing happens. Wow, how come nothing is happening? Let's double click on object 0 and we're going to enable physics for it. Let's click on uses physics, and yeah, if you run this now, you are going to get an error message. We have to modify the collision first before this works. So let's do that now. Oh wait a second, we actually have to use the circular collision. Let's place it. That looks fine there. Let's go to the room and let's run this. That works fine. Okay, we have no collisions yet. Let me just change the background color. I don't like the background. That looks much better. Let's enable physics for the ground. Let's adjust the collision shape. This is off by default for some reason. And it looks good there. And let's run this. Okay, so now we have the problem that both of them fall, and we don't want the ground to fall. That's an easy fix. All you have to do is set the density to 0. Let's run this. And that works fine. But we have no collisions. So let's create a collision. Let's go add event. And then we're gonna go to collision. Collision with object 1, which is the ground. You don't actually have to enter anything here. You can just simply enter a comment and it will work. Drag that there. And let's run this. That works fine. So let's double click on object 0 and let's go new step event. Now to make this jump, we're going to apply an impulse to this. I'm going to use a set direction because I don't think this does anything for physics. So let's bring out physics. And we're going to apply a force. Let's make this a relative to itself. And we have four parameters for this. Okay, so we got the X and Y. And the X and Y for the applied force. Let's set this up to X and Y. And we want to apply a force to the Y position. Let's try it out. Okay, that's not very strong. Let's try 100. 100 is still not strong enough. Let's try 500. Minus 500. Let's see. And 500 works fine. So now we want this to work only if we press a key. Let's find if key pressed. Let's bring this inside the key pressed command. Now for the key, I'm going to select the up key. Try it out. Press the up key. Okay, that's not strong enough because now it's not a constant. Okay, so we need to set this to super high. It needs to be a very high impulse. Let's try 3500. And press up. Not too bad. Not too bad, but let's try 9500. Press up. And that's more like a jump already. Now the gravity is a little weak, but we're gonna fix that. Let's see, set the gravity to 30. You can set it to whatever you like. Okay, that looks not too bad. Okay, looks like we got out. We have no collisions with the walls. So let's fix that. So let's add a collision with object 2. And yeah, we don't have to do anything. We simply have to enter a comment. Enter the comment. Where is the comment? There is a comment. Let's enable physics for the walls. And let me set the density to 0. So it's not going to fall. We had the same error message. Let's fix the collision shape. Okay, that looks good. Straight out. See if the ball leaves now. So let's see if we can get our ball to collide with the walls now. Do it. Come on. You can do it. You can do it. What do I have to do to get this to roll to the right? There we go. And it stops. So that works. Okay. So far so good. We're getting there. So now let's make it so we can roll to the right or to the left. Let me just copy this. And let me change the key to left. Now for this it wouldn't make sense to apply force. Okay, because the friction from the ground. Okay. So instead we are going to use torque speed. Let's go physics. And let's find torque. There you go. Torque, we're going to set it to minus 6500. And let's run this. And let's press left. Wow, we almost have no traction. And that's because our friction is maybe too low. Let's increase the friction. Let's set this to maybe 50. And let's try it out. There we go. That works fine. Much, much better. Let's do the other direction. Let me just copy this here and paste it. Let me change this to the right key. And instead of minus 6500, we're simply going to set it to 6500. Let's run this. Here we go. Now we can move to the right. And we can move to the left. Bang! We can bang in things. And we can jump. But we're not done yet. If you keep pressing up, you can continue to jump. And we don't want that. Okay. Maybe double jump, but not unlimited jump. Otherwise, we have to rename the game to the flying ball. Yeah, so let's create a new variable. Let's go create. Let's make a variable. Where is my where are my icons? Alright, okay, I found the icons. I was zoomed out too much. Let's call this let jump. And the value is going to be 0. Keep having trouble zooming in and out. Let's return to a step event. And our jump is only going to work if that variable is set to 0. Okay. Let jump. Let's drag if pressed into our if statement. Okay. We are going to set the variable to 1. So this will disable this action. Let's drag this right under the jump. Try it out. Okay, so we can still double jump. Let's see what is going on. Let me output a variable to see what's going on. This is why I made this object with a Z. Okay, so let's create a draw event. And we are going to draw our variable. And we're going to draw let jump. Let's drag our object into the screen. And let's run this. Okay, we got an error message. It couldn't find that variable. Now, you don't need to make that a global variable. You can actually target that from here. So all you have to do is type the name of the object. The name of the object is object 0. Okay, and that should work. Let's see, there we go. Caption 1 is displaying our variable. So that's already displaying a 1. Let's see why. Let's drag this after the jump. Okay, set to 0 now. And now it's set to 1, and now I can no longer jump. Okay, so my jumping has been disabled, which is good. So now let's go to the ground collision, which is object 1. Collision with object 1. We're gonna set let jump back to 0 when we collide with the ground. Okay, set to 0 now. Jump. You can see that we get a double jump by default. Alright guys, if you like making your own games, make sure you hit the subscribe button down below. Thanks for watching, smack the like button, and I will see you in the next video. Bye now.